Welcome to the Vector Garden. Now, you might have heard that a logo should always be a vector file. And yes, that is true. Because as a vector file, you have a broad range of use cases. You can convert it into any kind of file format. You can even convert it to pixels. Now, the question is, how do you know if the file is a vector file? And often people say, well, you know that by the file format. So there are typical vector file formats such as EPS, PDF, and SVG. And then there are proprietary file formats such as AI or Affinity Designer. And then there are typical raster formats such as JPEG or TIFF or PSD. And that's how you can tell. Now let's take a closer look at it and bust some myths. I'm going to start with the EPS. And I'm collecting things. So let's take a look at this document, which is the manual for Photoshop version 5.0. That is not CS5. That is version 5. So let's take a look at the section about saving files. And here it recommends that you need to save an EPS if you have a duplex file, or if you want to save the color separations or multi-channel files. And it does not only recommend that, but that was the only way to save these for desktop publishing. So these are the kind of files such as this one. I've got one of these duplex files, and in it there were files saved with spot channel information. So raster images. Let's take a look at that. I'm going to open this in Photoshop, like in here, and we have the Pantone color warning because I don't have those libraries installed currently. Let's zoom into this, and you see that is a pure pixel file. Now we can take a look at some of the spaces where you can even have vector information inside a pixel file, which is the paths. And you see no paths in this file. And we can take a look at the layers panel, and you see no shape layers in here. So that is a pure pixel file because EPS was the go-to file format during the 90s and of course later on to save that kind of file. There's no vector information in this file, and that's how it was meant to be. Let's go out of here and take a look at this one. This is a file I have saved in Illustrator. So let's open this in Illustrator and let's take a look at it. And you see it's empty. Let's take a look at the outline view. And there is this rectangle. So what's this? Let's go into, we can take a look at the document info to see what it is, but I know what it is. It's a linked file. So let's take a look at the links, and you see links are empty. So what I have done is place a raster file into Illustrator and link it, and then save this EPS and not include, so not embed the links. So this is basically empty and it has this kind of linked file in it, which is worthless without having the linked file itself. Again, no vector information in this EPS. Of course, EPS can have vector information in it, but it's not a given. So there can be anything in it. Let's take a look at the next one. So I'm going to PDFs. So let's take this PDF here, and I'm going to open it in an older version of Illustrator. And you see, I get the warning. The file has been generated by a newer version of Illustrator. Now, The file format of Illustrator has changed a little since version 2020, and actually all the files that you create since version 2020 can be opened in Illustrator 2020, 2021 to 24, of course, but that is only true if you save them as an AI file, but this is a PDF. So Illustrator cannot open that AI part of the file that is indeed embedded in this PDF, and it says some data loss might occur. Okay, so PDF is a vector format, right? Let's open this and let's go in here, and you see this looks quite as if it were pixels. Now, of course, it could be rectangles, so let's go to outline view again, and you see, well, obviously not. So looks like this is a pixel image. So let's go to the links panel, and there we have the image. So this is not useful if you have that older version. Now, I have created that in version 2024, so let's take a look at it in there. And you see there it opens. It can open the embedded AI file. And let's take a look at it here. So outline, okay, those are paths. And let's go to the preview again. So why does that look like a raster file? Because it has an effect applied. So let's go to the appearance panel. There we have the rasterize effect applied, so that always when you save a PDF, then this effect gets applied. And inside the PDF, there is a raster image. And inside the AI file, there are the paths. If you want to know more about how Illustrator saves file, I'm going to link a video in the description of this video so you can dive into the Illustrator file format, which is quite interesting in itself. But we see here, if we have the original version, then we can get at some information inside a file that we do not have when we use an older version. And of course, the same applies if you open files in different apps which are not the native apps that have been used to create the file. Let's take a look at the next PDF. So this one here. And let's open that in Illustrator and take a look at it. And you see when I zoom in, pixels. And again, let's go to the outline view. Well, those are not vector elements. Now, this is the typical graphic designer joke that people often, when they want to create a vector version of their logo, they take Word. So let's do that. You take Word and then you have that GIF from your website and drag that in, and then you save that as a PDF. But since we have already seen that saving as a PDF obviously does not automatically create a vector file, this will not work. So that's how this has been created, this file. The next thing, SVG. So here's an SVG, and again, we are going to open that in Illustrator. And again, let's take a look at the outline view, and you see, no, these are not circles. These are raster elements, and when we zoom in, we see the pixel edges. So this does not work because in Illustrator, I have applied an effect that automatically gets rasterized when saving as an SVG, because the file format SVG does not support this effect. There are some effects that SVG supports and renders live, and you can find them inside the SVG filters. So these are supported by the file format and everything stays vector artwork when you use them. Let's take a look at the next one. I'm going to open this one in here. And you see that was an AI file. And let's go to the outline view and you see again, it's a raster image. Because in Illustrator, you can place raster images. And if you do that, then of course, inside the AI file, there's no path, just those pixel images. And of course, that's not very usable either. So we have seen all these presumably vector files, which do not contain a lot of vector information. Now let's take a look at what these two raster files have to offer. It's a JPEG and a TIFF, and you see typical raster files. Let's take a look at them. I'm going to open the info. It's a 13 by 28 image. That's the image size. And that is not centimeter or millimeter. That is pixels. So this is really, really small. And if we do the same with this one, you see it's not larger. It's 50 by 50 pixels. So really small files, and if those are only raster, then they will be basically worthless. Let's take a look at that TIFF in Illustrator. I'm going to Illustrator, and then let's place this. Let's place this TIFF. There it is. I'm going to link it, and then let's just click. This is how small it is, and we zoom in, and you see, it's raster. I can enlarge it and still, those are just pixels, right? So we are going to embed this. And when we do this, we can convert layers to objects. So a TIFF can contain layers. Now let's convert them to objects. Okay. And you see, wow, that looks quite different. So what's this? I'm going to zoom in and you see there are no pixels. Let's go into outline view and it's a nice path in here. So what was this? That was a shape layer inside that TIFF. And if that TIFF is just linked, then that shape layer gets rendered at the resolution of that image, which was 50 by 50 pixels, so not that large. But if I embed it and convert that to objects, then I get that nice path that was in that image. Let's take a look at the JPEG. And for that, I'm going to use InDesign. So let's place that into InDesign. I'm going to do that. There's my JPEG. And you see that was just a rectangle. So let's do it. And I'm going to place it here. And you see, well, that was not just a rectangle. That's quite huge. And if we zoom in here, then you see no pixels. Where are those? So what's happening in that JPEG? Now that JPEG contained a clipping path. And I'm going to object. There we have clipping path, and we can convert that to a frame in InDesign like this. And when I then take the direct selection tool and select that pixel part of that JPEG and delete that, then I am left with a nice vector path that was inside that tiny JPEG. And this, of course, I can use, I can fill with a color, and I have that as a path. So as you have seen, things are not like they seem. So there are file formats that you considered vector, which just give you pixels, and then there are file formats that you consider raster, which have nice clean paths in them. So next time, when you tell someone what kind of file you need, you know, you need to be quite specific in what you are asking for. And next time someone asks you for a file, you need to ask more questions in order to be able to give them what they want.